Hello everyone. In our today's process costing 3 account lecture, we are focusing on the opening, where is the opening stock is given. On the basis of the opening stock of the work in progress, there are two types of method. First is FIFO method and second is weighted average method. First, we are solving the FIFO method. Let's start with the illustration number 6. From the following details, prepare the statement of equivalent production, statement of the cost, statement of the evaluation using FIFO method. The opening stock is given and percentage of the completion is also for opening stock is given. The number of unit introduced in a process is 21,000, closing stock is 6,000 units, stage of completion for the closing stock as well as opening stock, both are the given. Stage of completion. The 20,000 units are transferred to the next process. Following are the expenses: material, labor, and overhead. Right? So what we have to make? We have to make a 3 statement and account. So let's start. On the basis of FIFO method, we are solving the opening stock. This is a statement of evaluation. So when opening stock is given, first we have to write down opening stock. How much units? 5,000 units. Right? Level of completion is given? Yes, it's given. It is a for material 100% that become need. Whenever the material 100% is given, here it will become nil. Just because 100 minus 100, it will become nil. Whenever we are solving the opening stock, the 100% material is completed. That means all of the material are used. So while transferring to this account opening stock, that means 100% it will become nil. Then labor 60%. Then labor 60% is complete. So what is the remaining part? 40%. So here it will come 40%. Right? So 5,000 is 40%. It will come 2,000. Now overhead. Again 60% complete. Remaining part would be 40%. Understood? જ્યારે પણ ઓપનિંગ સ્ટોક આપેલો હશે ત્યારે આપણે જ્યારે લાસ્ટ મંથનું ક્લોઝિંગ સ્ટોક આ યરનું ઓપનિંગ સ્ટોક બને, બરાબર છે? બટ જ્યારે કમ્પ્લીશન સ્ટેજ 60 આપેલું હોય તો રિમેનિંગ પાર્ટ કેટલું હોય? 60 કમ્પ્લીટ થઈ ગયું, દેટ મીન્સ ઇન નેક્સ્ટ મંથ જ યુઝ થઈ ગયો. સોરી, પ્રીવિયસ મંથ જ યુઝ થઈ ગયો. રિમેનિંગ પાર્ટ કેટલો છે? 40% એ જ અહીંયા કમ્પ્લીટ લઈને આવે છે. સમજાણું? જ્યારે ઓપનિંગ સ્ટોક હશે ત્યારે જેટલું કમ્પ્લીશન હશે એને 100માંથી માઇનસ કરશું એટલે રિમેનિંગ અમાઉન્ટ મળશે. મટીરિયલ અહીંયા 100 હતું અને 100% કમ્પ્લીટેડ, દેટ મીન્સ 100 માઇનસ 100 વિલ બીકમ ની. સમજાણું? દેન યુનિટ ઓફ ફિનિશ ગુડ્સ. ફિનિશ ગુડ્સના યુનિટ્સ કેટલા છે? ટ્રાન્સફર કરીએ છીએ આપણે નેક્સ્ટ પ્રોસેસમાં 20,000. But as we have a closing stock, we have to deduct opening stock. First in, first out, right? So here the 5,000 we have to deduct. 20,000 minus 5,000, it will become 15,000. Right? અહીંયા નોર્મલ લોસ છે કે એવું કાંઈ જ ઇન્ફોર્મેશન આપેલી નથી, તો એબનોર્મલ લોસના પર્સન્ટેજ કાંઈ જ નથી આપેલા, એટલે એઝ ઇટ ઇઝ આપણે જઈએ છીએ. ફિનિશ ગુડ્સ હંમેશા 100% હોય, તમને ખબર છે. લાસ્ટ ક્લોઝિંગ સ્ટોક. ક્લોઝિંગ સ્ટોક છે 6,000. લેવલ ઓફ કમ્પ્લીશન છે 100%, 60%, 40%. 6,000, 6,000 60%, 3,600, 6,000 40%, 2,400. right? Let's total. $26,000, $21,000, $20,600, and $19,400. Number of units for a material 21,000, for labor 20,600, and for overhead 19,400. Now, statement of the cost. First, three costs are given: material, labor, and overhead. First is material. Expense is given 4,20,000. Equivalent unit is 21,000. It will come cost per unit 20 rupees. Then labor. Labor cost is given 3,09,000. Equivalent unit is given 20,600. So cost per unit 3,09,000 divided by 20,600. It will come rupees 50 cost per unit. Now overhead 1,35,800. Equivalent units is 19,400. Cost per unit will be 1,35,800 divided by 19,400. It will become 7. The total cost per unit 20 plus 15 plus 7, it will come 42 rupees. So cost price will be 42 rupees. Now we are making the statement of the evaluation. First, opening stock. Material, labor, overhead. For material, it is nil. For labor, it is a 2000 units. For overhead, it's also a 2000 units. Into price. So for labor price is 15 and for overhead price is 7. So 15 and 7. It will come 30,000 and 14,000. Total will be 44,000. Right? Now second, finished goods. Total finished goods are 15,000. Price is 42 rupees. You can write like this also: material, labor, and overhead. 15,000, 15,000, 15,000 into 20, 15, 7. Answer will be same. So we can directly put like this also: 15,000 into 6,30,000. Now, last closing stock. Material, labor, overhead. Material would be 6,000, 36,000 and 24,000. 36,000 and 24,000. Price will be 20, 15, 7. It will come 1,20,000, 54,000. And 16,800. Total will be 1,90,800. Right? So we have completed the statement of evaluation also. Now we are making the process account. First, we write down the opening stock 5,000. Price would be 44. Sorry. Price would be in given 29,000 in a sum. Price would be 29,000 is given. Now material, that transferred. Units would be 21,000. This one units 21,000 into amount would be 4,20,000. Labor 3,09,000. Overhead 1,35,800. Right, this side by finished goods units would be 20,000. Finished goods, total finished goods we are transferring from the next process is 20,000. Here amount will be differ. In the FIFO method, first we have an opening stock of the last year at rupees 29,000 at given in the sum. The new value of the 44,000 we have added, right? And finished goods amount is 6,30,000. So what would be the total? 29,000 plus 44,000 plus 6,30,000. It will come 7,03,000. 7,03,000. Why we are putting this value? Just because remaining 100%, 60% and 60%, that value we have already given in the sum of at value of rupees 29,000. Remaining part we are used in this process, right? So that value would be 44,000. So 29,000 plus 44,000 and plus 6,30,000 for finished goods that we have prepared at a 15,000 units, like. So 29,000 plus 44,000 plus 6,30,000, it will come 7,03,000. Now closing stock. Closing stock would be 1,90,800. The units is 6,000. Right? Let's close the account and you will get the answer. Same, right? This is a FIFO method in which we have to deduct the opening stock value in the finished goods. Just like a 20,000 minus 5,000 opening stock, finished good would be 15,000. Just because first in, first out. Understood? This is a FIFO method. Now we are solving the illustration number 9. Carefully understand that the same method, FIFO method, is there. From the following information, prepare a process number 2 account. In earlier all the sum we have a make a process number 1 account, right? In the process number 2 account, the transfer from the process 1 also, opening stock over there also, new additional material included, it will be there also, right? So we are making a process number 2 account. Opening stock and degree of completion is given. Transfer from the process account 1, 30,000 units at rupees 304. Transfer to process account 3, it is 24,800. Expense input in the process account 2, so material, direct labor and factory overhead. Unit scrap 32,000. Degree of completion of the unit scrap is given. Closing stock 3,60,000. Degree of completion is given. Normal loss is 10% of the production and the scrap value is rupees 1 per unit. Here the unit scrap degree of completion is also given, right? So let's start with the equivalent production. So first we start with the again opening stock. Opening stock is given 1600. Degree of completion of material is 80%. So remaining part would be 20%. For labor 70%. Remaining part would be 30%. And overhead 50%. Remaining part would be 50%. Right? So 1600 20%, 320. 1600 30%, 480 and 1600 is 50%, 800. Right? This is the opening stock. Now, normal loss. As normal loss is given, normal loss is given at 10% of unit introduce. Now, percentage is given 10% of production. Right? So, first we have to find out the production. So, for the production, we are adding the opening stock plus opening stock would be 1600 plus transfer from the process account 30,000 units minus closing stock. It will come 2800. Opening stock plus 30,000 transfer from the process 1 and minus closing stock. Carefully remember, opening stock plus inputs from the process 1 minus closing stock. It will come 28,000. The normal loss is 10%. It will come 2800. As you all know, the level of completion would be always nil. Now, the actual unit scrap is 3200. So, minus 3200, it will come 400. What was this? It is the abnormal loss. So, abnormal loss is equals to 400 units. Level of completion is given. Yes, 180%. 180. Whenever the completion of the abnormal loss is not given, we are assuming that will be 100%, right? So 400, 100%, 400, 480%. It's a 320, and here it's a 320. Right? So opening stock, normal loss, abnormal loss. Now finished goods. Finished goods, we are transferring 24,800 to process 3 account minus opening stock. Opening stock is 1600. We get 23,200. Right? The for finished good, it will always be 100%. Now, closing stock. Closing stock is 3,600. Degree of completion is 80, 50, 50. 80 would be 2880, 50 would be 1800 and 1800. Let's total units is 31,600. 320 plus 400 plus 23,200 plus 2880. It will come 26,800, 25,800 and 26,120. So we have to find it out the equivalent production, FIFO method. Now, statement of cost. First, which material we are transferring from the unit process account 1. So first is process 1 material. It is transfer at 18,304. Right? Minus normal loss. Normal loss is 2800 into rupees 1. It will come 2800. So 18,304 minus 2800. It will come 15,504. So for the process 1 material, equivalent unit would be different for the process 1 account. So the unit introduced on the process 1 is 30,000. Out of 28,000 is normal loss. So 30,000 minus 2800, it will come 27,200. So 15,504 upon 27,200, it will come 0.57 rupees. Now process 2 material that we are input in this process, right? So it is given 8040. Unit would be 26,800. So price would be 0.30. Now labor is given 28,380. Units will be 25,800. The price will be 1.10. Now overhead, overhead price is given 36,568. Units is 26,120. Price will be 140. The total cost will be 3.37. Whenever we are preparing for the process 2 account, so two type of material will be there. There is a material transfer from the process account 1 and additional material that we are introduced in the process account 2. Understood? For the process 2 account, material is also given, and the transfer from the process 1, two types of material will be there. So while preparing the statement of the cost, we have to carefully deduct the normal loss out of the process account 1 material, right? So there will be two types of material when we are preparing for the process number 2 account, right? Now we are preparing the statement of evaluation. First, opening stock. Here two types of material, material 1, material 2, labor and overhead. For the material type 1, we don't have any opening stock, right? So we directly put for the material 2, 320, 480 and 800. So 320, 480 and 800. Sorry. Price for material 2, labor and overhead. Price for material 2 is 0.30, 1.10 and 1.40. 0.30, 1.10, 1.40. It will come 96, 528 and 120. 1120. Total will be 1744. Now, abnormal loss. Abnormal loss completion is given. Same, material 1, material 2, labor, overhead. For the material 1 and material 2, the our unit would be same. So 400, 320, 320. So 400, 400, 320, 320. Price would be 0.57, 0.30, 1.10, 1.40. 0.57, 0.30, 1.10 and 1.40. Value. Now, finished goods. Finished goods is $23,200 into total price would be 3.37. So 3.37. 23,200 into 3.37. It will come 78,184. Right? Last part, closing stock. Material 1, material 2, labor and overhead. For the closing stock, 280, 800 and 800. So closing stock for material 1 is the same, 3600, right? So 3600, 2880, 1800 and 1800 into 0.57, 0.30, 0.110 and 0.140. The total amount would be 7416. 7416. Understood? There are two types of material, material 1 and material 2. In each, the when abnormal loss is there, the value of the material 1 and 2 remain same. The fixed good is the total units and total cost per unit. In the opening stock, there is no material 1 will be there. They are assuming that is 100% of the completion, so it will become nil. And for the opening stock, the 100% completion we are assuming, so it will be 3600, 2880 for material 2, labor and right. Now preparing the process account. First thing is opening stock 1600. Opening stock value is given 4400. Now normal wastage 2800. Here it will become 2800. Then abnormal wastage 400 and price would be 1148. Now additional transfer from process 1 account, unit would be 30,000, price would be 18,304, that is a given. Now material 2, 8040, labor 28,380, overhead 36,568. Now buy, transfer to process 3 account, unit would be 24,800 as it is a given. Right. Then transfer from process through would be finished goods amount is 78,184 plus both the value of the opening stock. So it is a 4400 also and the value of the 1744. Answer would be 84,328. Now last thing is closing stock. 3600, amount would be 7416. Let's total it out. You get the same side, same value on the both the sides, right? This is the sum where there are two kind of material would be there, right? Thank you.